Hello everyone, myself M.A. Mahant, working in Computer Science and Engineering Department as an Assistant Professor in Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are discussing the topic Implementation of RPC Mechanism in Distributed System. Learning Outcomes. At the end of this session, student will be able to implement RPC Mechanism in Distributed Systems, describe different formats of request and reply message. RPC Model. Actually, RPC means Remote Procedure Call Model. It can be used as an IPC mechanism to communicate between processes on different machines as well as between different processes on the same machine. This is the figure of RPC model in which the left-hand side shown is caller and right-hand side shown is callee, where caller call the procedure and wait for the reply. It will be sending the name of the method or function and the parameters of the method or function in the form of request message to the callee. So request message can be sent from caller to callee. So after receiving the request at the callee side, it starts the procedure execution. The callee will be execute the corresponding procedure and the result will be sending to the caller in the form of reply. So at the callee side, send the reply and wait for next request. So reply message can be sent from callee to caller. After getting the result at the caller side, caller should resume its next execution. Implementation of RPC. To achieve semantic transparency, the concept of stub is used in implementation of RPC. Stub hides the interface of the underlying RPC system from both client and the server processes. To hide the details of underlying network, an RPC communication package known as RPC runtime is used both on client and server side. Components of RPC. Implementation involves five elements: the client stub, the RPC runtime, the server stub, the server. This is the figure of implementation of RPC mechanism. Here, the client will be calling the procedure along with its name and the parameters, and it will be sending to client stub. Client stub will be keeping all these things, name of the function or method or parameter, it in a particular format by using packing, and it will be sending to the RPC runtime client. So client stub is sending the format to the RPC runtime of client. RPC runtime client will be sending this call packet to the RPC runtime server. RPC runtime server, after receiving this packet, it will be sending to the server stub. Server stub will be unpacking the parameters and name function, and that get executed. It will be sending to the server, and that method will be executed at the server side, and the result will be sending to from server to server stub, and server stub will be packing that result into particular format, and it will be sending to RPC runtime of server. RPC runtime server is sending this result packet to the RPC runtime client. Client, after receiving this result, the RPC runtime is sending it to client stub. Client stub will be unpacking this result, and it will be sending to the client. And after returning the result, the client will be getting the proper output. So this is the implementation of an RPC. Now we are going to see the role of client, client stub, RPC runtime, of server, RPC runtime client, server stub, and server in detail. Client. The client is a user process that initiates a remote procedure call. To make a remote procedure call, the client makes a perfectly normal call or local call that invokes a corresponding procedure in the client stub. Next component, client stub. The client stub is responsible for carrying out the following two tasks. The client stub is responsible for carrying out the following two tasks. On the receipt of a call request from the client, it packs a specification of the target procedure and the arguments into a message and then asks the local RPC runtime to send it to the server stub. Second one, on receipt of the result of procedure execution, it unpacks the result and passes it to the client. RPC runtime client. The RPC runtime on the client's machine receives the call request message from the client stub and sends it to the server machine. It also receives the message containing the result of procedure execution from the server machine and passes it to the client stub. On the other hand, RPC runtime on the server machine receives the message containing the result of procedure execution from the server stub and sends it to the client machine. On the other side, it also receives the call request message from the client machine and passes it to the server stub. The job of server stub performs the following two tasks. On the receipt of the call request message from the local RPC runtime, the server stub unpacks it and makes a perfectly normal call to invoke the appropriate procedure in the server. On the other hand, on receipt of the result of procedure execution from the server stub packs the result into a message and then asks the local RPC runtime to send it to the client stub server. On receiving a call request from the server stub, the server executes the appropriate procedure and runs the result of the procedure execution to the server stub. RPC messages. Client initiates RPC by using normal local call that invokes client stub. Client stub does the two things. One is marshalling, another is unmarshalling. Marshalling means packs a specification of target procedure and arguments into a message and sends to the RPC runtime. Unmarshalling means unpacks the result and passes it to the client. RPC messages. RPC runtime handles the transmission of messages across the network between client and server machines. It is responsible for retransmission, acknowledgements, packet routing, and encryption. Server stub. Server, on receiving a call request from the server stub, it executes the appropriate procedure and returns the result to the server stub. Think and answer. Pause the video and write the answer. In RPC mechanism, packing of message data is called as dash, marshalling, unmarshalling, no marshalling, or none of these. You have to choose any one option among these four options. The answer is option A, marshalling. In RPC mechanism, packing of message data is called as marshalling. RPC messages. There are two types of messages are involved in RPC. Call messages and reply messages. Call messages used by client to request execution of remote procedure. Reply messages used by the server to return the result. RPC is independent of transport protocols. It deals not only with the specification of and interpretation of these two messages. RPC call message format. So this is the figure of call message format in which the it should be having the different fields such like message ID, message type, client ID, remote procedure ID, in which it will be recursively three columns, program number, version number, procedure number, and arguments. Two basic components, the ID of the remote procedure to be executed, arguments necessary. A message ID that consists of sequence number. From this, we can find the lost and duplicate messages and for machine reply with the call. A message type field used to distinguish between call messages from reply messages. This field set to 0 for call messages and set to 1 for reply messages. A client ID field for two purposes. To identify client to whom result has to be returned. To allow server to check the authentication of the client. Reply message. Reply message may be successful or unsuccessful. Both the messages have the different format. The figure reply message format for successful message, reply message format for unsuccessful message. Reply message consisting of the columns message ID, message type, reply status, result. So message ID will be same for the as that of call message. Message type field is set to indicate that it is a reply message. For successful reply, the reply status field is set to 0. For unsuccessful reply, the reply status field is set to 1 or to a non-zero value to indicate failure. If non-zero value, then value indicate the type of error. When the server receives the call message from a client, it could be one of the following condition. The server finds that the call message is not intangible to it, or it violates the RPC protocol, or server rejects. Another reason, client is not authorized to use the service, server returns the unsuccessful reply. Remote procedure ID specified does not exist, server returns unsuccessful reply. Server procedure not able to decode the specified arguments means it incompatible with RPC interface being used by the client and server. An exception condition occurs while executing the remote procedure, for example, divide by zero, executed successfully and result returned. Marshalling and results and arguments. So marshalling involves taking the arguments of a client process or the result of server process that form the message data, encoding the message data on the sender's computer, means conversion of program objects into a stream form suitable for transmission, decoding of the message data on the receiver's computer, means reconstruction of program objects from the stream form. For successful encoding and decoding of RPC message, the order of and the representation method, tagged or untagged, must be known to both the client and server. This provides the type of safety between client and server. The marshalling process must reflect the structure of all types of program objects used in the concerned language. These are the references. Thank you.